Michael Church, Crawl Space Ninja. Today we're going to do an essential guide to whole home humidity control. In my opinion, the number one problem your home faces is probably high humidity. Now, of course, water in general is a problem, flooding is a problem, but the thing about high humidity is it is often overlooked, misunderstood, and not caught until it's too late. So hopefully this video will help you all. Stay tuned. So if you're new to Crawl Space Ninja, we talk about everything related to crawl space encapsulation, humidity control, indoor air quality. We hope you'll subscribe to our channel, ring that notifications bell, follow us on Facebook. Make sure you check out our DIY store and our franchise opportunities. Why is your home humid in the first place? Well, keep in mind that as your AC runs, part of the job of the air conditioning system is to lower humidity. And if you, like us here in Tennessee where we live, and it's humid all the time. Today it's supposed to be 95 degrees, gonna be humid outside. Well, that humidity wants to go in to the house. As the humidity inside the home gets lowered, okay, let's say you've got the AC and it's kicking out 40% relative humidity and the humidity outside is 80%, that humidity is trying to drive itself into that low humidity. It's similar to whenever you're watching the weather channel or something and they talk about the high chases the low. Well, that's very similar. The other problem is that your home leaks. You've got plumbing issues, you may have a wet, damp crawl space from flooding, you got condensation problems because you're running your AC, and then this hot, humid air comes through the open or vented crawl space and hits that cold ductwork and starts sweating and leaches and causes humidity to go crazy. So the importance of controlling humidity is huge, but the damage of humidity is even worse. High humidity leads to mold. It can even affect virus growth inside your home, bacteria growth inside your home. It affects ozone pollution levels. It affects asthma, also dust mite production. So there's a lot of things that are related to humidity, whether it's high or low. So what we're going to talk about is we're going to take you through different parts of the house, which parts you should focus on to control humidity, and some things you can do to control the humidity. So let's talk first about the basement. There's a lot of basement waterproofing contractors out there that really focus on how to eliminate flooding in the basement, which obviously is super important. Nobody wants to have their drywall and their carpet and their furniture flooded, because then that flooding can give off high humidity if it's not done properly. Basements just flood over time, whether your basement is finished or unfinished. You're always gonna have potential flooding issues as, you know, your footer drain outside gets damaged and the downspouts get clogged up. That water just sits around the foundation and wants to come inside of the house. But what we have found is that a lot of basement waterproofers out there and homeowners out there overlook humidity control. Even if the basement has been waterproof properly and all the flooding is addressed, you're still gonna have a high humidity issue in most basements. And the reason why is because typically, even if your basement is finished and conditioned, your thermostat doesn't kick on as often in the basement because the basement tends to be cooler. And remember, part of the AC's job is removing humidity as it cools. So if you have a basement, I would encourage you to get some kind of continuous monitoring system like a humidity reader, and we've got a link to that down in our DIY store. That way you can keep a constant look on the basement year round. Now in the winter, you're probably gonna have a drier, less humid basement, but in the summer when that humidity kicks and all that humidity is trying to rush into that basement, like I mentioned earlier, having a great dehumidifier that covers the entire square footage of the basement is a great idea. Humid attics. Now, this doesn't happen very often because most of the time an attic is pretty dry unless you have a roof leak or your flashing is giving you a problem or maybe the siding is allowing moisture to come in. But we have installed dehumidifiers in attics whenever you have a really hot, humid outside environment. Maybe there's too much ventilation and your air ducts are up there. So your HVAC system is up there and you've got really poorly insulated air ducts, or they're leaking really bad, and that hot, humid air enters into the attic and then causes that condensation inside around that ductwork in the attic and everything, and just creates a huge problem. Now, normally the humidity doesn't get really bad in an attic, but that condensation is then dripping down on your drywall or your ceiling, and then creating mold issues underneath that blown in insulation. And the next thing you know, you look up and you got like this yellow stain on your drywall. And sometimes that can happen even if you have boots in the ceiling. So your HVAC system is blowing cool air from the ceiling down, so your boots can condensate and sweat. So we recommend that you take a look in the attic. You can put one of those humidity control devices up there just to make sure that it's not getting out of control. But secondly, if your HVAC system is up there and it's in some kind of drip pan, make sure you put like a water alarm inside that drip pan, so that way if it leaks and floods because the condensate line gets clogged, you'll be able to catch that quickly before it becomes a mold problem in the future. So now I want to talk about humidity's effect on you and your home. Did you know that high humidity will actually make you feel less comfortable in the summer? It's typically called the heat index. So if it's 85 degrees outside and the weather person says it feels like 106, that's because it's the temperature mixed with high humidity causes it to feel warmer. So if you'll control humidity in the entire home, it's not that the temperature has lowered, it's that your body actually recognizes that it feels cooler, because as humidity rises, it doesn't allow your body to sweat properly. That's why in jungles and different places like that, people have actually died from there being too much high humidity. And I'm not saying you're gonna die in your house from high humidity, but you may feel like it because you're hot and you don't know why you're hot. So controlling that humidity is gonna make your home feel more comfortable. The other thing it's going to do is, as I mentioned before, it's going to help with dust mite populations. If you've got children, the biggest reason why we got involved in indoor air quality in the first place was because when my kids were about to be born, I had asthma as a kid, you know, and nobody knew why. They said I outgrew it as I got older. Well, come to find out, we lived in some pretty nasty rental properties that probably had mold everywhere, and there was high humidity. My parents were smoking cigarettes and all this other stuff. But I started researching what causes asthma problems, and did you know the number one cause of asthma among children is actually dust mites? And dust mites thrive in a high humid environment. So you want to make sure you control that humidity to control different indoor air pollutants that are causing you and your family to properly have some sinus issues and even some asthma attacks. I get this question a lot. What is the best humidity level for my home? Well, typically the best humidity level is going to be between 45 and 55%. Not that things can't happen in that humidity level, but there's a great graph, and I'm going to put a link down to it below. We did a blog a couple of years ago, and it shows what thrives in a low humidity environment and what thrives inside your home in a high humidity environment. And if you look down the chart, it shows between about 45 and 55% is the best humidity level in most circumstances. Now, if you've got some kind of medical problem or something like that, obviously check with your medical professional to see what they recommend the best humidity level is. But when it's kept between 45 and 55%, it's not that dust mites can't grow in that level. It's not that bacteria can't grow in that level, but it retards the growth or the expansion of those allergens, and it gives it a better place to where mold and different things like that aren't thriving out of control. So make sure you keep your humidity level between 45 and 55% all the time. I tell you, another really overlooked part of your home that causes high humidity inside the living space is actually your garage. It's all the time I'm driving down neighborhoods and seeing things where people's got their garage door open, even if it's like a foot open so that their animals can jump in there if they need to or whatever. But leaving that garage door open just allows that high humidity outside to infiltrate your garage. A lot of garages have an HVAC system installed in them, but even if it doesn't, there's still a high humidity buildup inside that garage, whether your garage is finished or not. And then once you open your living space door, where does that humidity want to go? It wants to rush straight in to that living space and affect the humidity inside there too. And many homes are built with a basement attached to a garage. So you got basement humidity, you got garage humidity that you're fighting. So if you've got a heating and air system outside in your garage, I certainly recommend that you put in a dehumidifier. But if your house is like mine, where your garage, you maybe got a bonus room sitting up or a bedroom on top of the garage, putting a dehumidifier in that garage should make that bonus room or that extra bedroom upstairs feel cooler too, because all that hot, humid garage air wants to move right up into the room above it. Another thing you did, and we did a video about it many, many years ago, was you should try to air seal the wall between the garage and the living space. So if you've got an opportunity, if it's an unfinished space, for example, try to air seal and insulate that wall before you put up drywall or something like that. Air seal around the door. Try to keep as much of that garage air from getting into the living space as you can. So crawl space humidity control is pretty straightforward. You want to make sure that if your crawl space is flooding, you want to address that flooding the best you can. Typically, according to HUD, you want to make sure you put in a full perimeter trench with a sump pump anytime that the dirt inside the crawl space is lower than the dirt outside. Not only will you get infiltration through the foundation wall, but you're also going to get the potential of that water table raising up inside the crawl space, which is why HUD, the Housing and Urban Development Government Agency, recommends that you install a full perimeter trench and a sump pump. But you also want to make sure you have a properly installed vapor barrier. Make sure you air seal the vents, all but one. If you've watched any of our videos, we talk about why you should do that. And then you install that crawl space dehumidifier to control humidity. Okay, don't try to let nature control humidity in the crawl space. Even if you've got an HVAC system, which a lot of people like to do, they'll put a return and a supply from the HVAC system into the crawl space so that it controls humidity. But like I mentioned before, if that HVAC system isn't running enough to control that humidity, then it's gonna get really high in that crawl space and you're gonna have insulation absorbing moisture. Your wood's gonna absorb moisture, which is gonna create mold problems, gonna be a good place for critters to come. So as a backup, even if you're using your heating and air system to control humidity in your crawl space, which I don't recommend, then also install a dehumidifier as a way to make sure that it stays controlled year round. The last thing I want to talk about is your living space. If there's a part of your home, maybe a wet area where you're coming in from the outside, you know, a landing or something like that, that you're taking off your nasty shoes, or maybe there's a part of the house you don't go into very often, get some of those humidity readers and put in those areas to keep an eye on that humidity year round. You can also install the April Air E-Series dehumidifiers in every place that I talked about, in the attic, the basement, the crawl space, and even the living space and the garage. You can hook the April Air dehumidifier up to the ductwork so that it becomes part of the HVAC system. So if you're concerned about humidity inside the home, maybe you're on a slab, so you don't have to worry about a basement, you don't have to worry about a crawl space, but perhaps you're on a slab, you can install that dehumidifier to run through the HVAC system, whether the HVAC is on or not. It's going to control humidity inside the entire home. So you want to make sure you control humidity to prevent molds and different things like that. It's a lot easier to prevent mold and a lot less expensive to prevent it than it is to deal with it after it's gotten root in your house. So I'm Michael Church with Crawl Space Ninja. We hope you make it a happy and blessed day, and we'll see you later.